So great you could be with us again. I am with Greg Engert, beer director for the Neighborhood Restaurant Group, a food and wine sommelier of the year. The group includes Vermilion and Columbia Firehouse in Old Town. Then just over in the Delray neighborhood, you've got Evening Star Cafe and Planet Wine. Greg, it is always good to see you.
You too, Brennan.
Oh, it's a big bottle. What do we have on tap this week?
So this week we have one of the most amazing beers in the world. It's from Brewery Dre Fonteinen, a small lambic brewer and blender in the Payottenland, which is the farm region, formerly farm region for the most part, that surrounds Brussels in Belgium. Their original location is in Biercel. That's where they brew. They do some aging and blending there as well. But they have a new location called Lambico Drum in Lot, which is where they have even more of their huge barrels. They exclusively make lambic, spontaneously fermented beer from Belgium and the Payottenland, oak barrel aged. This particular brand is called Armand and Gaston, and it is the from 2016. It is a Geuze lambic. So one of the most amazing drinks in the world.
So good, and it's got a taste to it. I almost want to say, call me crazy, and I am, sesame seeds, something, a grain of some type, but it's delicious. Yeah. I love that.
It's like an oaky quality. There's acid, obviously, there too. It's got like almost a crystalline quality on the palate. Really bright lemon, pineapple notes in the nose, good oak character, hints of funk and earth, but not overly funky, but altogether restrained and balanced, and only about 5.7% alcohol. So very, very drinkable. Re-fermented in bottle like champagne for this wonderful, natural, creamy, but effusive effervescence. Fantastic. And so as a Geuze, this is something that has been blended from different ages of lambic. So they start, when you make lambic, it's very simple. 60-65% barley, malted barley, 35-40% wheat. They do a long boil on it. They add old hops to fight off some infection, give you a little bit of hop character, nothing crazy. But then rather than after the boil of cooling it down through a heat exchanger and then adding yeast, pitching yeast into it in a stainless steel fermenter, they bring in the warm, hot, piping hot liquid into a cool ship. It sits there overnight in cool temps. Wild, naturally occurring yeast and bacteria will start to come in. The next morning, they'll transfer the contents of that cooling ship into oak barrels, where it will rest for 6 months, 9 months, a year, 2 years, 3 years. And then from there, you can make anything with it. If you take some of that lambic at 1 or 2 years and add cherries to it, that becomes creek. If you do the same and add raspberries, that becomes framboise. But if you take a little bit of old 3-year-old barrel-aged beer, some 2-year-old and some 1-year-old, blend it into bottle where it re-ferments, that's this. It's called Geuze.
What would you pair it with?
This is traditionally, Geuze is one of the most amazing things to pair with any food. It's fantastic with seafood of all kinds, acid to balance salt, lemony character to liven everything up. So, you know, shellfish, bivalves, lobsters, oysters, crabs, mussels, incredible. There's, you know, they have mussels that are prepared with Geuze. It's amazing. They have chicken that's prepared with Geuze. That's another thing that's fantastic. Also great with like kind of funky cheeses, goat cheese, blue cheese, grilled cheese sandwiches, really great egg dishes. Like you have this with like quiche or omelets, or even like an egg sandwich. That's amazing. And then the best thing to do with lambic, I think, is charcuterie and meat, sausages. But the other day I was drinking one of these, not by myself, but at my house, and I had it with like an Italian hoagie, and it was amazing. So Italian subs also work great with Geuze lambic.
I think this is one of my favorite beers ever.
It's so cool.
Beer of the week. A, because it tastes so great, and B, because it was so fun to talk about.
Yeah, totally. And last thing I want to mention about it is, yes, it's called So, Dre Fonteinen is a brewery that it's been around since 1953, and they were just blending lambic at that point. So there's still a tradition in Belgium, which is so cool, where you don't even brew, you just buy lambic, age it in your barrels, and then create your own blends. Dre Fonteinen did that from 53 until the late 90s. They started brewing, did that for a decade, took a little hiatus, and now they're back brewing again. But they still buy lambic. So if you just see the regular Dre Fonteinen Oude Geuze, it is also perfection. But that's a blend of lambic they make, brew themselves, but also other people's lambics, like Lindemann's and Bone, that's aged on premise and blended. The Armand and Gaston is 100% Dre Fonteinen brewed lambic. So it's the best, it's kind of the creme de la creme of what they produce. And it refers to Armand, who's the current owner, and his father, the late Gaston, who handed the business off to him in the early 80s.
Greg, thank you as always.
Thank you.
Everyone, please always do drink responsibly and be sure to bring your thirst next time for another beer of the week.